My name's Mickalene Thomas, and I'm working on my vinyl mural at the Norton Museum with my team, Jeff and Rob. And we are putting some layers of paint on it to bring forth some of the vibrant colors that exist in a collage, the actual collage. Make it come to life. The whole image is vinyl. The process is starts with a collage that's created, and then it's created again digitally, and then it's scanned and then blown up to this size. So it's these images are based actual from digital images and also from actual photographic images that I have. That is there. There was a little sliver. Here we go. All of these sort of photographic images are based particularly from Florida, you know, Florida's landscape. And I juxtapose them with some of my resources that I use in my collages, like linoleum, the faux linoleum, some collage material that I find, color aid, like all of these flat planes of color is the color aid shapes that are cut out and then collage together to sort of create a depth of field of space. And for me, I'm interested in those layers of shapes and how those shapes can sort of define space to create a landscape. I've been doing landscape painting or working with landscape images since 2008. When I did my first landscape, and that was based on some Hudson River School paintings that I was interested in. Since then, either based from my travels or based from just resourcing images from particular areas, I started collaging my own resources with found resources and creating landscape images. Conceptually, because my work is photographic based, and speaking to some of my friends who work with digital images, they suggested, why don't you try scanning the images and then blowing them up sort of photographically and printing it on a vinyl. So it still sort of pertains to the same process that I work within, which was very exciting because I always wanted to do mural projects, but never really conceived of how that process could take shape. Because my materials are so vastly different, and to try to scale up or create a linoleum piece to that size would be a little arduous and really expensive if you were to sort of collage that actual piece on it. I use a lot of Photoshop and photography. It seemed to make sense to work this way and then come back into the collage and add my own elements back on top of it. Because it's all based from the original source, like this is an actual collage that exists, so you could sort of, it's almost becomes hyper-real in a nice visceral play between the image and allowing the image to exist in several forms. Taking a collage that's this size and sort of bringing it to life on this sort of scale is quite exciting. But this particular mural was all mainly created digitally, which was really exciting. That's a sort of new process where I can take my photographs, and to have the image much sharper, we can play with these shapes on the computer. So you can actually cut out the shapes photographically in sort of Photoshop, which is nice. And I like playing with sort of the reality of images, of the elements of what's real and what's fabricated and what's reality versus fantasy. These are very real elements that exist in the world, whether they're fake materials, found objects, photos from Flickr because someone else took them, or my own photographs, or someone's experience that they can relate to this lily pad, whether it's in Florida or in Monet's garden. There's a reference. There's references that are familiar to the person that's looking at it. The printers, it takes them about a good week of getting it, you know, sending them the image and doing a lot of color correction. And then once they get here, the install can take anywhere from a week to 2 weeks, depending on how large the... We did a project similar last year at the Barclays Stadium. That was twice the size. Actually, we're a little ahead, so I'm going to do some other things that I've been wanting to do with the mural that I didn't think I would have time to do, since we have we're ahead a little. I won't speak too much about being ahead of ourselves.